teach you mathematics. So first of all, did you all complete your holiday homework which was given to you? I think yes. So now whatever I am going to teach you, I will be giving you specific instructions where the work should be done. Some I may explain on the board, and some you are already having your textbooks with you. So you will be doing a few in the textbook, and then a few in the classwork, and then a few in the homework book. Which to be done where, I will be telling you. So according to that, you will be doing it. I am going to start the first chapter in mathematics today. Before starting it, let us recapitulate what you have learnt in class 2. You know to read and write numbers till 9, 9, 9. What are these 9, 9 and 9? These are called as digits. So these 9, 9 and 9, in the number 999, we call them as digits. We have 1 digit numbers, which are from 1 to 9, and 2 digit numbers, which are from 10 to 99. And you also know the 3 digit numbers, which start from 100 to 99. In this, if you see 1 digit number, so you have 1 digit in the number. You can also call it as number 1 till number 9. And the 2 digit numbers, if you see, you have 2 digits in the number. That is, a number has 2 digits in it. So you call all the numbers from 10 to 99, that is 10, 11, 12 and so on till 99, we call them as 2 digit numbers. 3 digit numbers, you have 3 digits in these numbers. You know that this we call it as 100 and this we call it as 999. So you have 3 digits in these numbers. So we call them as 3 digit numbers. Just we will now have a recap of all the concepts which you have learned about numbers. That is, how do you write and read the number names of a 3 digit number? If you take the number, say it as 524. I know very well that you know how you read or write this number. So before reading or writing the number, you should write down the places of these numbers, which are the 4 is in the 1's place, 2 is in the 10's place and 5 is in the 100's place. To make it easy for writing the number name, you need to divide this 3 digit number into 2 parts, wherein for writing the 3 digit number as the number name, you need to write the 100's place first and then you can combine the 10's and the 1's place. So I said that you are writing the 100's place number first. What is the number in the 100's place here? You have the number 5. So 5 is in 100's place. So write it as 5, 100, 2, 4. I said these two, you will be telling it at a time. So which is 24, which now you will write it as 24. Now the number name for this number, you will write or read it as 524. I told you, remember that the 100's place, write or read it separately, and 10's and the 1's place together. In the same way, if we give another example, if I tell the example as 777, here also you have the 100's place as 7. So first move on from the 1's place, 1's, 10's, 100's. And I told you to write the 7's place first for the numbering. So you will write it as 700. In mathematics, chapter 1 is numbers up to 9, 9, 9, 9. Children, just now I told you, how many digits are there in this number? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are 4 digits in this number. So you can open chapter number 1, page number 1 in your mathematics textbook, which almost looks like this. I didn't draw all the figures, all the pictures of the houses and all. Wherein, if you see in the page number 1, you have first a child named Rohit. His house number is 246, which we read it as 246. And the second child, Nitya, her house number is 862, which is 862. The third child, Deepak, whose house number is 471, 471. Fourth child, Neha, 399, 399. The fifth child is Vicky, whose house number is 571, 571. Sonal, whose house number is 148, which you read it as 148. Well, you know very well now to write all these, read all these numbers. Now, in page number 1, you have, the next is, write the number names of these children, the house numbers of these children in number name. Yes, shall we start doing it? So, you have the first boy as the first child, Rohit. What is Rohit's house number? You have the house number as 246. Is it 246? So, you will, how to write the number name? I told you, this is the hundreds place. You are very familiar with hundreds, tens and ones place. So, which is hundreds place here? 2. And I told you that number names, always the hundreds place should be written first, which is 246. And children, also remember that whenever you are writing a number name, the starting of the number name should always be a capital letter and rest of all should be small letters only. In between you have 40, so don't write it as F as capital letter and 6 as capital letter, only write them as small letters. And while you are writing the number name, please take care of your spellings, wherein 40, don't write it as a spelling mistake. Write it as F-O-R-T-Y. Many of you will write it as F-O-U-R-T-Y. Is it 40 or 40? It is only 40, not 40. So write it as F-O-R-T-Y only. Now, who is the second child here? Nitya. What is the house number of Nitya? 862. So write down here 862. And write the number name of 862, which is, start from the hundreds place, 800. So write it as 862, which is 62. Third child, Deepak. What is Deepak's house number? 471. 471. First hundreds place 4. So 471. The fourth child is Neha. Neha's house number is 399. So hundreds place you have the number 3, which you will write it as 399. The fifth child is Vicky, whose house number is 571. So write it as 571. Children, while I am doing it, page 2, you have starting with bit number 2, the children whose house names, house numbers are given there, you need to write them here, which they have specified here. First, you have the name of the child as Rohit. What is the house number of Rohit? 246. 246. House number of Sonal is 148. 148. House number of Nitya is 862. 862. House number of Deepak is 471. 471. And last, the house number of Neha is 399. Now, according to the question, you need to write this, all these numbers, the names, the house numbers of all these children in ascending order. What do you mean by ascending order? Arranging the numbers in from small to big. So, which is the smallest number in this? First, we need to see the numbers in the ones place. 200, 100, 800, 400, 300. Which is the smallest number? 1. So, first, tick it and write down so that you won't have any confusion and you can know that you have completed writing this number. So, first, you will write the number as 148. 148. We wrote the house number of Sonal. The next biggest number is 200, 800, 400, 300. 200, right? So, write Rohit's house number, which is 246, 246. Tick it and write, please. And next, you have Neha's house number, which is 399. Deepak's house number is the next, which is 471. The biggest in all these numbers is 862. Please don't forget to tick and write, as these are smaller numbers which you can easily identify, but going on, if you have bigger numbers or larger numbers, you may face a difficulty. So, I am asking you to tick and write the numbers. So, you have arranged all these numbers in ascending order. That is, smallest number 148 and next is 246, 399, 471 and 862. So, these are the numbers which are, these are the numbers of the house numbers of these children which are arranged in ascending order. Now, moving on to bit number 3, you have to show these children's house numbers in on the abacus. So, first, before doing starting the abacus, you need to write the house numbers of these children. What is the house number of Rohit? 246. So, write down here 246, or it's better that you write here also, but it's okay, you have been given a box. So, write first in the box the house number of Rohit, which is 246. And then if you see, first I told you that always we will start from the ones place, and on the abacus also, this is the ones place number, this is the tens place number, and this is the hundreds place number. So, what is the digit in the ones place? The digit in the ones place is 6. So, you need to draw 6 beads on the ones place on the abacus. So, always remember that on the abacus, never you will start drawing the beads from the top. Because when you put the beads in the abacus also, we will start, the bead will go from down. So, always start it from the bottom. So, draw 6 beads in the ones place, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Next, how many beads should we draw in the tens place? 4. So, 1, 2, 3,